set to go. We're gonna head out for a mission today. I'm gonna aim to get some crayfish and some fresh scallops for dinner. And so we're gonna try and find a spot on the harbour for a camp. Get a feed first and yeah, perch up, wake the tent up, get the barbie going and yeah, just have a nice overnighter. Can't wait, excited, so that's great. Been wanting to do a overnighter mission for a while and just escape all this crazy stuff going on in the world at the moment. Just get up by myself for a bit of peace and quiet. So yeah, hopefully I don't have much cell phone reception there and yeah, have a good night out next to the water camping. I'm bloody excited, so yeah. Jump in for a dive and get that feed, get the tent up and have a cook up before it gets dark, so yeah. So I couldn't find my little gas cooker and I'm not sure what bits of wood and stuff they've got on these beaches, so yeah, we'll take the Weber. Boom, whack that in the IB. Easy. Pop the gear up now, get my wetsuit on and probably the only downfall really of these IBs is as they're a soft hull, you've got to carry these motor, you've got to carry your outboard in the back of the car for these long trips, otherwise yeah, there's a lot of stress on these transoms and stuff that are joined, but it's not the end of the world. Oh, look at that. It's just a beautiful evening. Calm as anything. So, let's get this bad boy in the water. It's pretty shallow. Just whip that motor up. Drag her off. That's the benefit of these IRBs, they're just so light, so one person might bug me, just drag them off and drag them back on. So yeah, launch any tides. You'll find these all around New Zealand beaches, so it's good to know your limits and sizes for anyone who's unsure. Here's a scallop target today, 100 mil. And what else are we after? Crayfish. Crayfish, where are you? Actually, I can't see crayfish on there, so
that's right. I know the rules.
I know the size limit, and should be pretty easy to find a legal one here. I'm just going to grab one for dinner. More than enough. Alright. IRB's waiting for me. Incredible, still even. Woo.
Thank you.
just halfway to my spot, and the surface is just alive here with fish. Looks to be car wide. There's birds dive bombing this whole area. Not sure if you can see that, but yeah, lots of fish around here. It's just very green and not very concentrated, otherwise I might jump in and got my little gun here, and just in case we do see some fish today, like a nice trevally for dinner, but staying overnight with minimal ice and stuff, I don't really want to get any fish, so maybe in the morning. Alright, we'll cruise on. Alright, I've come to my spot here. So I've allowed 20 scallops per person per day here, and I don't really need that much today. If I do, cool, have a few for breakfast, but otherwise I'll be just happy with, you know, 10 or so for dinner. So current's still pushing really hard, so I'm just going to do a bit of a drift dive, get myself to the boat, and yeah, just make it easier, and I'll just move my way down the bay doing a drift, and hopefully I can pick up a fair few on one drift and move on to some crayfish, but we'll see how we go. Water's so warm at the moment, so no bottom wetsuit on today, just a top. Alright, let's get into it.
Righto, I get straight into it, diving down into the green water. Once I reach the bottom, I've got about 1 to 2 meters visibility, and I'm just searching for that unmistakable white frill of a scallop hiding in the sand. No luck on that first dive, but I'm down once again into the green water and hit the bottom the second time, and I'm straight on top of a good patch. So I don't muck around and grab as many as I can on that breath hold. You can see the shape of the scallops here, just bedded down in the sand. You can see that white frill and the unmistakable shape. So once you get your eye in for them, they're easy to spot, and in a place like this you can get a feed and limit very easily.
All right, got on the patch there. Whew. I ran out of breath, could have kept going. Alright, chuck those in the boat and get back down.
Even in shallow water like this, it can be quite difficult to calm the mind. In dirty green water like this, all sorts of thoughts race through the head, like sharks and everything, because you just can't see much. So it's a good test. You've got to be strong in the mind and time in the water. Many dives in dirty water, you get there in the end, and it's just all about lowering that heart rate, calming the mind, and then you can have a longer breath hold.
All right, that'll do it. Go find a cray. Geez, really good on the patch today. Awesome. Right, one, two, that's too small. Five, six, legal, seven, that's well legal. Eight, nine, cut myself there on something. Oh, well, there we go. Beautiful. Got my 20 scallops. Gonna be amazing. Cook them up soon in the barbie. Whew. All right. That was pretty successful. Almost got my limit in about three dives, and then just had to grab a couple more at the end and had a little bit of salt, threw a few small ones back, and yeah, too easy. So scallops for dinner already, and just gonna tuck around the corner a bit and try and find some cray. So too good. So still, it's beautiful. Ridiculous. So yeah, all going to plan so far. I literally jumped in, swam towards the rocks, and just dove straight down and grabbed a cray. Plenty around, got some footage, and yeah, cool. That's dinner well and truly sorted. So anchor up. I'm gonna shoot over and try and find a nice beach to park up in a sheltered bay somewhere for the night, and we'll have a cook up. Let's do it. Awesome beach, no one here. It's looking pretty promising, so we're just gonna cruise around a bit more. Not a person in sight, not a boat in sight. It looks like it's gonna be my little beach for myself for the night. Oh, it looks like I spoke too soon. We've got some cattle that check them out. Looks like I've got company tonight.
Gnarly country, yeah, pretty cool. Look at that. Big steep cliffs. Dark green water. Very deep. So yeah, we're gonna tuck up over in there. It should be sheltered out of any wind, and
oh, we're starting to lose a bit of light, so gotta get set up.
spears as well, so pretty keen to tackle for those. Right, I think I'm just gonna smash the boat up on the beach here. Drag it up into that high tide mark there, I reckon. Here's our beach for the night. Got some beefies on the corner there. And just gonna find a nice little spot up in this grass here maybe. And yeah, cool. Made it. Got our dinner and something set up this way. Just moving the boat along the beach here. Bit better access up here. Birds have got nests, so I'd better stay clear. Oh yeah, there's a little chick there, so I'll go over here out of their way. They're not happy. Yeah, a couple little chicks around here. Find a little camping spot. This looks good. Right. Sweet. Barbie's set up. Time to unpack the tent. I've got all my stuff in the dry bag there, so whip all that out. I've got a little table, chair, Barbie, even got my little sun shower. It's not very warm, but it's going to be fresh water and nice rinse off before I sleep. So yeah, a bit of a gentleman's camping, but hey, why not? Pretty easy. People often ask what's the point in a two-piece open cell wetsuit. Days like this when it's super hot, super warm water, generally in summer, North Island here in New Zealand does get quite warm the water, so a 5mm suit can be a bit warm. So like I just did today, you know, shorts. Still got my neoprene socks on with the fins just for comfort, but yeah, just the top perfect, so there you go. That little mozzie mesh in case the mozzies want to come in, but yeah, there's my little one-man tent set up for the night. Beauty. Righto, tent's done. Have a quick shower, refresh, and yeah, we'll extract some scallops and a bit of an entree and then, yeah, crave the main. Life's tough.
20 litre bag. Find a bit of a treat. That should do us. Alright. There we go.
Alright, better keep it PG. I'll see you back at campsite.
Look at this. Beautiful little pond. You probably won't be able to see it in the camera, but there's a huge pheasant cock right up there behind the left of that tree. You can hear him. It's a couple around, I think. Awesome. Look at these scallops, man. These are just in beautiful condition. Look at that. Awesome. So we'll shuck these all up now, and then if I don't eat them tonight, which I doubt I'll get 20 through me, I'll have a bunch for breakfast. So beautiful. Give them a wash in there if we need to, and can't wait. Chucking these scallops and they are all just in just fantastic condition. Look at the row on that, just vibrant bright rows, every single one of them. So I just gave them a quick rinse in there and yeah, let's go eat. Right, so I've just got this little screw in propane and Barbie are ready to go. Sweet. Give it a test. Let that heat up. We'll just get some salt and butter on that, keep it simple, and that's going in here as well. Heating up already. Awesome. Oh yeah.
I think better after a diet. Probably the worst thing you should be doing. Getting some liquid into you, not alcohol, but hey.
Man, this thing heats up quick. Yeah, 200 degrees already. So, put some of those aside and then we'll cook up about half of them. Bit of a grey evening.
Should have a good night in. Neat little tent anyways. Very waterproof, well built, so shouldn't have any issues there anyways. It's a bit wet, so. Thank you.
finish it off. All right, let's start with these scallops, eh? Beauty. Probably just turn that off. That just to finish off. Oh, there we go. And need that one. Oh yeah. Give these a go. Ooh, hot. Oh no. Literally were burying themselves in the sand trying to hide from me about an hour ago. My favourite seafood scallops are just amazing. Very lucky to live in this area where I can just go and get a feed of scallops, grab a cray, pretty much any time within the seasons. So, yeah. Look at this. Beautiful bay. Beautiful backdrop. Yeah, and we'll kick it back in here tonight. I haven't got any sort of pillow or mattress, but sand's pretty soft, so we'll be alright. Beautiful. That's done. And that's dinner. That's the life. Cheers, guys. Try some of this cray. Yeah, look at that tail just ripping out there. Oh, that's just fresh. Beautiful cray. Woohoo! Pretty good crayfish, but I still rate a scallop over a cray. Everyone's got their own preferences, eh? All seafood's pretty good. Right, I'm gonna enjoy my dinner. Might see you later. Might go for a cruise on here and see what's around this little bit of coastline. So, peace. Touch base later. Little chicks and birds have moved, they're roosting up in there, so that's good. Keep our distance, everyone's happy. 8 o'clock now, so I think the sun's just nipped down behind the horizon, and we'll start to cool off a bit now and darken up, so might gather a bit of driftwood and have a bit of a wee fire. Be rude not to have a fire beach camping, so plenty of driftwood around. Driftwood's not the best for cooking on. I hear it's quite toxic, releases some chemical, can't remember exactly, but got mentioned to me in another video where I was cooking up some mussels, so yeah, gave it a Google, and sure enough it seems to be quite toxic, quite bad, so we'll just have a fire to keep warm. And And yeah, got the barbie to cook food on, so such a good evening. That food was just delicious, as usual. When it's that fresh, you know, it's pretty hard to stuff it up. It's always good. Look at this beach all to myself, amazing. Old tree here in the sand. Nudge around the corner here, see what we can find. Looks like we're going to be cut off by the tide there. Tide's still just coming in, or it might be full tide around now, so yeah, might head back before I do get cut off. Alright, let's go get a fire lit. Got one more beer, that might be us for the evening. Little tennis ball. Not a bad kick. Oh, pine cones. That'll go good on the fire. Plenty of good dry stuff to get the fire started, so shouldn't be too hard. Grab a couple of these. Yeah, man, this is it. Oh, a bit miles there. We're away. Oh yeah. Oh, nothing beats a fire on the beach, man. Amazing. That's going real well. Get these pine cones on there. Oh yeah, they're the best. We're away. This is what I want. This is the perfect end to the little day. Oh yeah, too good. Whew. That's the one, guys. That's it. Beautiful. Must be time to crack that other beer. Oh, there we go. So good. So yeah, hey, a few of you might be wondering about this hat, maybe you're not. Anyways, I am launching this brand probably by the time this video uploads. I should have the website live, okay? I've just been working on this for the last few months. It's my brand, Primal Pursuit, so that goes out to everyone out there in nature with that primal instinct, that primal, you know, you're just chasing that thing we all have in us, so which is, yeah, camping, fishing, diving, hunting, all of this good stuff. So yeah, that's the name, Primal Pursuit. Gonna have a couple hats ready in the next week, probably by this time this video's live, and I've got a few t-shirts on the way, and next year we're gonna expand. So if you want to grab one of these, if you like the look of that, it's a five panel snapback. Real good quality comfy hat. I've got some bucket hats as well. If you're keen on one of these, stay tuned on my Instagram. I'll be doing some posts and updates about that. Otherwise, yeah, hit me up in the comments below if you're not on Instagram, or find me on Facebook. So yeah, if you want to support me and my channel, grab one of these. I'm sure you'll like it, and yeah, appreciate any support. Probably can't see my face, but it's just magic. There's no cell phone reception on my phone as well, so there's no temptations to scroll through those pointless, meaningless social media pages, and yeah, I'm not missing out on anything. Oh, it's bliss. Everyone's got to do this, eh? You got to get out into nature. Either leave the phone at home or go somewhere where there's no signal, because it's just amazing. I did a trip down to Fiordland at the beginning of the year for the Aurora, and it was just amazing. A week of pretty much no cell phone reception. It's just it's a good reset. Even one night out like this is just, it's just awesome. So highly recommend. Oh, it's just so good. Just thought I'd check out the water's edge here, and these schools of fish cruising around. There's bait fish right up here in the shallows, so I do have my spare gun. It'll be interesting to see what comes in the shallows later, maybe some kingfish and stuff. Probably can't be bothered spearing a kingfish at night, but yeah, might see some sharks. Interesting. Righto, it's been chilling out for a few hours. Super dark now, frogs are croaking somewhere over there, possums are running around, pretty knackered, so yeah. Crawled onto the tent and call it a night. Beauty. Oh yeah. Right, I'm out. It's bloody hot, so I'm just gonna lie on the bag, and I'm actually reasonably comfy for now. I'm sure I'll have a shit sleep, but we'll see you in the morning for a nice big coffee. Peace out. Oh, boat's still there, that's good. Whew. Not the best sleep as predicted, but not too bad actually. I think I'm just gonna have coffee, pack up, and that wind's looking like it's picking up, so gotta grab a few more scallops to take home, and yeah, be on my way. There we go. Espresso, got a nice bit of creamer on there. Awesome. Oh man, it's good as well. Really good. Not joking. Not talking shit. It's good coffee. Oh. Better than my machine at home actually. This is such a cool little unit, Nano Espresso. It actually seriously makes a good shot of espresso. So yeah, perfect for out camping or out on the boat somewhere fishing, hiking. Just need a little jet boil, get some hot water and or a thermos, and yeah, you're away. Pretty cool. Well, I'm charged up again. Pretty poor sleep, but two shots of coffee. I'm back in action for a while, so whip down the tent. I think everything's still here. There were possums running around all last night. I could hear them making their screeching horrible noise and a few other weird noises, as you do when you're out camping. But looks like that boat's pretty well stuck in the sand here, so probably, oh no, should be able to move that alright. Tide's coming in, so yeah.
Boat's ready, dry bag, barbie and all that stuff, dive gear ready just to grab a couple more scallops, and yeah, rain's coming in.
Quickly go shoot, grab a feed of scallops. I'm not too hungry, so I didn't cock me up this morning, so yeah, just a few more to take home, and yeah, pretty sweet little ride tonight.
Just grab this anchor, and we're away.
boats, and that's the end of the trip. Cruise back to the boat room. Whew. Made it back. Sweet little adventure. Well, hope you enjoyed that, and plenty more to come. If you're new to my channel, check out my other videos. Heaps of diving, spearfishing, a bit of hunting, and probably a lot more camping this summer. So yeah, if you want to see more, click subscribe, and yeah, if you enjoy, thumbs up. And yeah, appreciate all your support. Shout out to all my channel members for your ongoing support, my Patreon members, and everyone who's donated through Buy Me a Coffee. And yeah, check out my merch once that drops if you want to support. And yeah, see you next time. Cheers.